Hey guys, this is Tom from Virtual Tours Creator, and this is the ultimate guide on how to create virtual reality tours for real estate and real estate only. There is plenty of different advice on the internet, but if you are interested in real estate and real estate only, this is the tutorial that you want to see. We focus only on real estate. I've done probably 100 or more virtual reality tours myself. If you're shooting with one-click cameras, not DSLR, this is the tutorial for you. This is what you want to hear, and this is what is gonna give you, I hope, all the knowledge that I have, and I hope there's not much left. So if you're ready, let's go. In today's tutorial, I'm gonna talk about camera distance from the walls, camera versus mirrors, a few more examples of exposure in bathroom and dining rooms, kitchen photography, and how to avoid obstacles on the floor around the house. I now transferred myself magically to the bathroom. Unfortunately, it's a tiny bathroom, so I can't fit in that camera inside to show you everything. So I'm just going to talk about it. So please pay attention and watch what I'm doing with the camera. I could obviously shoot it in 360, but then it would be difficult to present it to everyone as a normal video. So let's start with placing the camera and the tripod. I will just tell you that over here in front of me, there's a mirror. There's a mirror on the whole wall. And you might have watched other tutorials on the mirrors. You would know how to set up the camera against the mirror. But if you didn't, let's do it this time. And first of all, we have to have that camera probably right in the middle of the room. Don't put it too close to the walls, because how our virtual tours creator system is set up is that when you walk in from the hallway to this bathroom, you're gonna be looking directly opposite the way to where you came from. So if you're gonna have the camera or the tripod here close to the wall because you think you will see more of this side of the bathroom, when somebody is gonna walk into this bathroom, they're gonna look at the wall, okay? This is not the view that you want. That's why you try always to keep it right in the middle so people have some space to breathe. And also the 360 image is gonna automatically pan around, so even if you're looking at that corner, it's gonna get out of that view and gonna look at where you want them to look. But not to have the whole camera in the mirror. Instead of pointing it this way and you can see the whole camera, you can always turn it around and have the edge of the camera looking at the mirror so that it kind of disappears from the image. But as we said before, the most important thing is what you want to show your customers. So you probably are interested in this sphere where the basin is and the cupboards and the mirror, and you don't want that stitching line being in the middle of your view. You also have to watch the downlights to see if there's no lines. But as I said before, the lines are secondary. So the main thing is to point the camera so that you can have the main point of view in one lens, okay? So something like that, exactly where you are sitting and watching me. That's how we point the camera, and that should give us a beautiful 360 image of the whole bathroom. Obviously, you can play with the exposure because it might be a bit darkish. Then you would set up the exposure to, let's say, plus half or plus one. You can see it in the preview live. So once we finally finished with the long hallway, with the all the bedrooms and bathrooms, we can come back to the easier part. We're back in the living, dining and kitchen section. And as you remember, we had the tripod probably just about where you standing to take the photo of the living room and the hallway on the crossroads of everything. So now we want to take one photo of the dining room and also one photo of the kitchen from what I call the outside. You have to remember that you always, no matter what, have to take two photos of the kitchen. One from the outside, so you can see how it looks like. And then one of the inside, which we gonna do in the next step, because your viewers want to exactly see how the kitchen looks from inside, how the cupboards, how the drawers look like, or what appliances you have in the kitchen. And in here, I will just show you two settings to play with exposure. So the first photo is the exposure set up to zero. And the second exposure is minus one, just to dim down the windows a bit. And that should give you an idea of what you prefer. It's getting a bit late and darkish, so I have to hurry up because we're gonna need some more light. It's probably our last location, the kitchen. As I mentioned before, you have to have one right in the middle of the kitchen. So let's set up the tripod in the middle so the viewers can see everything. But the only thing that you would have to check now is if it's not too dark. So you should open your app and go to the exposure, as I showed you before. Open it up and I'm gonna take two photos. One with the zero exposure. You can see it now. Might be a bit dark. So I'm gonna go the opposite way and gonna brighten up the room and gonna shoot one with plus one. That's how it looks with plus one. You can see that the cupboards in the lower cupboards in the kitchen are a bit brighter, although the windows might get a bit blown. So it's your decision again, what's right, what's wrong. These are just my hints. One last thing, always remember to take the photo of the back of the house. Unfortunately, it just started raining, so I won't be able to go to the garden, but normally I would put the tripod right in the middle of it so you can see the whole house from the back. You can see how beautiful this deck is, and you can see the garden, the neighbors' houses, and whatever surrounding the property. But for now, we're just gonna take one photo of the deck. You could also take a separate photo of the deck and then of the garden if it's a big property like this one. So all you have to do is put it right in the middle and press the magic button. One very important thing that you may not pay much attention to is the problem of putting the tripod too close to any objects. In Virtual Tours Creator, we have an added patch that automatically covers the tripod with a circle logo of your choice. So you have to remember that if you're gonna have the tripod, you're trying to put the tripod always in the middle of the room, but sometimes you're gonna have a nice chair or a couch or a table standing next to it, and you don't really want to put the tripod against any of those objects, because then you're gonna have your logo sitting on top of it. So in such case, you should probably move the tripod away from any object, if possible, around 30 to 40 centimeters. And that's gonna solve the problem of covering any objects with the nylon patch. Thank you.